first note, 2 sin square theta minus sin theta is equal to sin theta into 2 sin theta minus 1. If I take sin theta common, sin theta into 2 sin theta minus 1 is an identity. It is an identity. Whereas 2 sin square theta minus sin theta equals 0 is not an identity. In fact, it is an equation, not an identity, but it is an equation which is satisfied only for some particular values of theta. Equation satisfied only for some particular values of theta, whereas identity is satisfied for all the values of theta. Very important note. Then the second one, trigonometric ratios. T ratios means trigonometric ratios of an acute angle being ratio have no unit, and they are just a real number. Trigonometric ratios being a ratio, it has no unit and it is just a real number. Third note, we know that, at least you know that, in a right angled triangle, hypotenuse is the greatest side. Hypotenuse is the greatest side. Therefore, sin theta and cos theta values are always less than 1. Why it is less than 1? Sin theta is opposite by hypotenuse, you know. Hypotenuse is the greatest angle. In the ratio, if the denominator is more, then the value goes on decreases. Isn't it? Denominator jaasti adangella, a function value kami aagta barate. It is less than 1. Whereas secant theta and cosecant theta, look at the definition of secant. Hypotenuse divided by adjacent. Denominator kami iddu, numerator jaasti ide andre, obviously it is more than 1. That's why secant theta and cosecant theta, secant theta and cosecant theta values are always more than 1, whereas sin theta and cos theta values are less than 1, since hypotenuse is in the denominator. Also, tan theta and cot theta can take any real value, minus infinity to plus infinity. Tan theta and cot theta can take any real value. Note number 4. Trigonometric ratios depends only upon magnitude of the angle. Depends only upon the magnitude of the angle and length of the sides. Length of the sides. Next, note number 5. Sin theta whole square means sin theta into sin theta. X square can be written as x into x, you know. Sin theta whole square means sin theta into sin theta. It is also written as sin square. Sin square theta. Similarly, tan theta whole square can be written as tan square theta. And secant theta, the whole cube is secant cube theta, secant cube theta, okay, etc. Trigonometric ratios of angles in different quadrants, first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant and the fourth quadrant, that is nothing but sine, S-I-G-N, sines of trigonometric ratios. Let us see one by one. This is the origin. Say in the first quadrant, here is the point P. Let us say x comma y. From the point P, drop a perpendicular to x axis, say PM. the distance from the origin OM is equal to x unit and PM is equal to the measurement along y axis y unit. So here OP is the distance, OM is positive x axis, PM is a positive y axis. In the first quadrant, x and y both are positive, that's why all the trigonometric functions are positive. Okay, so as per the definition, let me take the second quadrant. X negative x axis, y negative y axis, here is the origin. Here we have a point P, okay, this is the distance R. From the point P, drop a perpendicular, so PM. PM is a measurement along x axis, so I mean y axis, it's a positive measurement. OM is a measurement along x axis, of course a negative x axis. This distance is minus x. See, here is the angle theta, here is the angle theta, whereas this is the angle theta. So here x is negative, look at the definition, sin theta is y divided by x, you know, y divided by x, y divided by r. R is the radius or the distance, you can call. Sin theta is y by r, positive. Cosecant theta is y by r, which is again positive. Whereas cos theta is x divided by r, you know, which is a negative quantity. Secant theta is also negative, r by x. So r divided by minus x means it is negative. Tan theta is y by x, that is y divided by minus x means, so tan theta is negative, even cot theta is also negative. So only sin theta, y by r, y is positive, r is always positive, isn't it? That's why sin theta and its reciprocal cosecant theta are positive in the second quadrant, whereas the remaining four trigonometric ratios, cos theta, secant theta, tan theta, cot theta, these four are negative, whereas sin theta and cosecant theta are positive. In case of first quadrant, all the trigonometric functions are positive because x, y and even r, r is always positive, you know, that's why. X axis, negative x axis, y negative y axis, here is the origin. Take a point P in the third quadrant. OP is the distance, which is R, we denote it as. From the point P, drop a perpendicular to x axis, say PM. Look at PM. MP is a measurement along negative y axis, you know, so this is negative y, and OM is a measurement along negative x axis, this is also minus x minus y. So the point, the coordinates of the point is minus x comma minus y. See, this is the amount of rotation, angle theta, okay. So minus x comma minus y. So in the third quadrant, take sin theta. Sin theta is y divided by r, you know, minus y by r means negative quantity. Sin theta is negative means obviously cosecant theta is r by minus y is also negative. Take cos theta. Cos theta is minus x divided by r, adjacent by hypotenuse, you know, minus x by r, it is a negative quantity, and secant theta is reciprocal of that, r divided by minus x, again negative. Whereas come to tan theta is opposite divided by adjacent, that is minus y divided by minus x. Minus y by minus x means minus minus gets cancelled, y by x, which is a positive quantity. So tan theta is positive in the third quadrant, and the reciprocal of that minus x divided by minus y cot theta is also positive. So in the third quadrant only tan theta and cot theta are positive, whereas the remaining four, that is sin theta, reciprocal cosecant theta, cos theta and its reciprocal secant theta, these four are negative, whereas only tan and cot are positive. Let us take the fourth quadrant. X-axis, negative x-axis, y-axis and the negative y-axis. Here is the origin. I'll take the point P here, join OP, which is the distance R, right? From the point P, drop a perpendicular PM. So the distance OM is the positive measurement, the measurement along x-axis, you know, positive x-axis, and the distance MP is along the negative y-axis, minus y. So here the amount of rotation is this. This is the amount of rotation, the angle theta here. So sin theta is minus y divided by r. So negative quantity, sin theta is negative. Cosecant theta is r divided by minus y. Again negative quantity. Come to cos theta. Cos theta is x divided by r. X divided by r. Cos theta is x by r, means adjacent by hypotenuse, you know. So which is positive quantity. And secant theta, reciprocal of that, r divided by x. Again a positive quantity. Whereas tan theta is minus y divided by x. So is a negative quantity. Cos theta and secant theta are positive quantity. Tan theta is minus y by x, means negative quantity. Cot theta is x divided by minus y, is also a negative quantity. So only cos theta and secant theta are positive quantities, whereas the remaining four, that is sin theta, cosecant theta, tan theta and cot theta, these four are negative. Only sin and its reciprocal cosecant are positive. Let us write the sines of sin, sine of each trigonometric functions in different quadrants. So sin theta in first quadrant, it is positive. Even in second quadrant, positive. Third and the fourth quadrant, negative. Come to cosine of the angle theta, positive, negative, negative and positive. In the fourth quadrant and the first quadrant, cos theta is positive. Whereas tan theta, first quadrant positive, negative, third quadrant positive and the fourth quadrant negative. Cot theta, so positive in the first quadrant, second quadrant negative, third quadrant positive and the fourth quadrant negative. Secant of the angle theta, positive in first and fourth quadrant, whereas negative in second and the third quadrant. Cosecant of the angle theta, positive in first and second quadrant, negative in third and the fourth quadrant. Okay, let us concise these in a quadrant, that is ASTC rule. ASTC rule. Please observe. X and negative x axis
y and negative y axis. This is the origin. From here to here, 90 degree. So this is the first quadrant, second quadrant, third, and the fourth quadrant. So in the first quadrant, from 0 to 90 degree, that means less than 90 degree, greater than 0 degree. So theta is greater than 0 degree and less than 90 degree. So the angle lies between 0 and 90 degree. In the second quadrant, theta is greater than 90 degree, more than 90 degree, and less than 180 degree. From here to here, 180 degree, you know. So theta lies between 90 and 180. In the third quadrant, theta is less than 270 degree and more than 180 degree. So 90 plus 90 plus 90, 270 degree. So less than 270, whereas greater than 180 degree. In the fourth quadrant, theta is one complete circle, that means 360 degree, less than 360 degree and more than 270 degree. More than 270 degree. So in the fourth quadrant, theta lies between 270 degree and 360 degree. ASTC rule, we call it as ASTC. Here, A stands for all the trigonometric functions are positive. S stands for sine theta and its reciprocal. Sin theta and its reciprocal, cosecant theta, are positive. Sin theta and its reciprocal, cosecant theta, these two are positive. Whereas the remaining four, cos theta, secant theta, tan theta and cot theta, these four are negative in the second quadrant. So come to the third quadrant. Here T stands for tan. Tan theta and its reciprocal cot theta. These two are positive. Whereas the remaining four, sin theta and its reciprocal cosecant theta, cos theta and its reciprocal secant theta, these four are negative. In the fourth quadrant, C stands for cos, not cosecant, cos. Cos theta and its reciprocal secant theta, these two are positive. Cos theta and secant theta are positive. Whereas the remaining four, sin theta, cosecant theta, tan theta, cot theta, tan theta, cot theta, these are negative. Okay, ASTC rule. All the trigonometric functions are positive in the first quadrant. S stands for sin theta and its reciprocal, cosecant theta, are positive. The remaining four are negative. T stands for tan theta and cot theta are positive in the third quadrant. The remaining four are negative in the third quadrant. In the fourth quadrant, C stands for cos theta and its reciprocal secant theta are positive, whereas the remaining four are negative. ASTC. All students take coffee, not now, after the meals. All silver teacups. Just to remember, this is what we call as ASTC rule. Next, let us discuss the problems based on these concepts. Exercise 3.2. The first question, worked example. If cos x equals minus 3 by 5, x lies in the third quadrant. find the values of other trigonometric ratios. X lies in the third quadrant they have given. Okay, X lies in the third quadrant. Recollect AST's rule. In the third quadrant, only tan and cot, as per AST's rule, only tan and cot are positive. Here is the angle theta, x negative x axis, y negative y axis. Here is the point P given. So here the angle is x, actually they have given, not theta, sorry, x. Given cos x is equal to minus 3 by 5. It is a negative quantity. Look at that. So this is, the, as per the definition, adjacent side divided by hypotenuse side. Okay. So if this is the angle, opposite side you are supposed to find. Okay. Adjacent side is 3 unit. Of course, minus 3 unit. And the hypotenuse is 5 unit. 5 unit. We know that square on the hypotenuse is equal to opposite square plus adjacent square. Hypotenuse is 5 square. Opposite is, you are supposed to find, adjacent is 3 square. 5 square means 25. 3 square is 9, minus 9. So which is 16. Square on the opposite side is 16 means, so opposite side is 4. Okay, so now let us write the other 6 trigonometry function. So secant theta, secant x is equal to hypotenuse divided by adjacent, you know, hypotenuse divided by adjacent. So that means 5 divided by 3. Of course, secant x in the third quadrant, it is negative. Then let us take sine of the angle x. Sine of the angle x means opposite side divided by hypotenuse side. Opposite side is nothing but 4. Hypotenuse is 5. In the third quadrant, sine theta should be negative, minus 4 by 5. Then let us write cosecant of the angle. Hypotenuse divided by opposite, 5 divided by 4. In the fourth quadrant, hypotenuse, so in the third quadrant, cosecant x is also negative. Then tangent of the angle, tan x is equal to opposite side divided by adjacent side. Here the opposite side is 4, adjacent side is 3. So in the third quadrant, tan x is positive, and cot x is equal to adjacent divided by opposite, which is 3 divided by 4. Both are positive. So in the third quadrant, tan x and cot x are positive quantities, whereas the remaining are negative. They have given cos x and ask us to find the remaining 5 trigonometric ratios. Next, question number 2, worked example again. If cot x equals minus 5 divided by 12, x lies in the second quadrant. Find the values of other 5 trigonometric functions, athwa trigonometric ratios. North zone 2013 in 2 mark. So look at, the angle lies in the second quadrant, you know, lies in the second quadrant. X negative x axis, y and the negative y axis. Here is the point P. So the point P is x comma y, perpendicular to x axis PM. See, this is the amount of rotation. This is the angle x. So opposite side, hypotenuse side and the adjacent side. So solution given cot x is equal to minus 5 divided by 12. As per the definition, adjacent side divided by opposite side, of course a negative quantity, adjacent side is 5, of course minus 5, opposite side is 12, they have given opposite side is 12. So we know that square on the hypotenuse is equal to opposite square plus adjacent square. So that is 12 square plus 5 square. 12 square means 144, 5 square is 25, so 169. So square root of 169 means 13. Hypotenuse is equal to 13. Hypotenuse is 13. So let us write the other 5 trigonometry function. Cot x we have enough. Tan x is opposite side divided by adjacent side. Opposite side is 12, adjacent is 5. In the second quadrant, tan theta is negative enough. Tan x is equal to minus 12 divided by 5. Let us take sin x. Sin x is, as per the definition, opposite side by hypotenuse side. Opposite side is 12, hypotenuse is 13. Clearly, in the second quadrant, sin x is a positive quantity, 12 by 13. Cosecant x, the definition is hypotenuse divided by opposite, which is 13 divided by 12. 13 divided by 12. And then cosine of the angle theta, cosine of the angle x, or adjacent side divided by hypotenuse side. Adjacent side is 5, hypotenuse is 13. So in the second quadrant, cosine of the angle is negative, minus 5 divided by 13. Then secant of the angle x is equal to hypotenuse divided by adjacent side, which is 13 divided by 5. Even secant x is also negative in the second quadrant. In the second quadrant, only sin x and its reciprocal cosecant are positive and the remaining 4 are negative. Next, third question, an exercise problem. If cos x equals minus 1 by 2, where x lies in second quadrant again, x lies in second quadrant, find the values of other 5 trigonometric functions. The angle lies in the second quadrant they have given. Recollect ASTC rule. As per the ASTC rule, S stands for sine and its reciprocal, cosecant or positive. This is the angle means opposite side, PM is the opposite side, OM is the hypotenuse side, and this is the adjacent side. They have given cos x as minus 1 by 2. As per the definition, adjacent side divided by hypotenuse side. Of course, adjacent side here is 1, negative x-axis means minus 1, hypotenuse is 2. You are supposed to find opposite side. We know that square on the hypotenuse is equal to opposite square plus adjacent square. So that is 2 square is equal to opposite square we are supposed to find. Adjacent is 1, 4 minus 1 is the opposite square. Opposite is root 3, opposite side is root 3. Now, secant x is hypotenuse divided by adjacent, 2 divided by 1. So, in the second quadrant, secant x is negative. We can write this as minus 2, of course. Then, sin theta, sin x is opposite by hypotenuse. opposite side is nothing but root 3. Hypotenuse is 2, root 3 divided by 2. So in the second quadrant, sin x is positive. Cosecant x, reciprocal of that, hypotenuse divided by opposite. Hypotenuse side is 2, opposite side is root 3, 2 by root 3. Cosecant x is also positive in the second quadrant. Come to tan x, opposite by adjacent side. Opposite side is nothing but root 3. Adjacent side is nothing but 1. Root 3 by 1 is nothing but root 3. So since tan x, a second quadrant means tan x is negative minus root 3. And cot of the angle x, adjacent by opposite. Adjacent side is 1. Opposite side is root 3. So cot x is also negative in the second quadrant. Minus 1 by root 3. The fourth question, an exercise problem. If sin theta is equal to 3 by 5, where theta greater than pi by 2, less than pi, greater than 90 degree and less than 180 degree, that means lies in the second quadrant again. Instead of giving the second quadrant, they may give like this: theta greater than pi by 2 and less than pi, or else theta lies between pi by 2 and pi also they may give. Find the values of other 5 trigonometric functions. Look at sin theta is 3 by 5, which is opposite side divided by hypotenuse side. So second quadrant, you know, greater than 180 degree and less than, greater than 90 degree and less than 180 degree. So this is the angle x, I mean theta here. PM is the opposite side. OP is the hypotenuse side. OM is the adjacent side. So we know that square on the hypotenuse is equal to opposite side, square of the opposite plus square of the adjacent. Opposite side is 3, hypotenuse is 5. So adjacent square, 25 minus 9 is the square on the adjacent side. So root 16 adjacent side is, so that adjacent side should be 4. 3, 4 and 5 are the Pythagorean triplets. You can write it directly, no problem. So I showed how to get it. Cosecant of the angle theta. So definition is hypotenuse divided by opposite. Hypotenuse side is nothing but 5 unit. Opposite side is 3. Adjacent side we are supposed to find, we obtained it as 4. Hypotenuse is 5 divided by opposite is 3. 5 by 3. Clearly it is more than 1, cosecant theta and secant theta. So hypotenuse, denominator, I have given the note, you know, hypotenuse is the biggest side. So as the denominator is more, the value is less than 1. Okay. Then let us take cosine of the angle theta. So the definition is adjacent divided by hypotenuse. Adjacent side is nothing but 4. Hypotenuse is 5. 4 by 5. So cos theta in the second quadrant means it is negative. Secant of the angle theta, which is hypotenuse divided by adjacent. So 5 divided by 4. Even secant theta is negative in the second quadrant. Only sine and cosecant are positive. So tangent of the angle theta. Tan theta is opposite side divided by adjacent side. Opposite side is 3. Adjacent side is 4. 3 by 4. It is a negative quantity. Cot of the angle theta is adjacent side divided by opposite side. 4 divided by 3, which is negative.
So only sine and cos are positive, the remaining four are negative.